As many of you know, yesterday we issued a silver alert for Miss Camilla Phipps. She is a 21-year student here at Jackson State University. And where we are now is still following leads as it pertains to her whereabouts. Information we received, we immediately began taking investigative steps to determine her whereabouts, reaching out to family, friends, and I would encourage anyone at this time, upon hearing me speak this morning, if you have any information, if you've spoken with her, or even if you've seen her, please call 601-979-2580. I repeat, 601-979-2580.
Chief, can you kind of give us an idea of, just kind of walk us through what you know as far as the timeline? And again, I don't want to ask you to, say anything that could compromise the investigation. Just kind of give us an idea.
Yes, sir. I understand. We received this information yesterday afternoon. And once again, as I mentioned, we immediately started taking action as far as taking investigative steps to try to determine where Ms. Phipps was located. One of the things that we do know is that she did, or someone, purchased a ticket from our Greyhound bus station, and that ticket destination ended in New York City. We're taking steps to reach out to our law enforcement partners in that part of the country to try to help us out with determining if she in fact arrived at that location by herself or with someone.
How did you find out she was missing? How long has it been?
We received this information right around yesterday around 1 o'clock. We determined that she had been missing since the 19th, and we started backtracking, taking those steps as far as setting a timeline on information that we received. And at this time, right now, we're still, like I said before, developing information based on those leads to help us locate Ms. Phipps. We're in constant contact with the family, with the mother, to try to any information she received. We have been constantly encouraging her to give us a call, and she's been doing that. She's been very cooperative in doing that, and I really appreciate her in helping us resolve this situation.
Do you know of anything that would provoke her to want to go to New York City? Like, was there a fight? Was she planning a trip? Like, do we know any of that?
We're determining that right now. We're not able to confirm her reason for going to New York. But as of right now, we know that that is the destination that the ticket that was purchased.
So a couple of people have reached out to us saying that a man followed a student around last week, kind of suspiciously, maybe went into a class. Can you confirm that for us?
No, I cannot, but I would encourage those individuals who have that information, please provide that to us, because we would be able to look at what we are able to look at as far as our cameras on campus, as far as the timeline in which they saw these things, because that would help us to make a better determination of what other steps we need to take.
What time did the ticket leave? Is it just like, what time was that purchased?
Right now, from what I'm able to recall, it was sometime Wednesday, which is the 20th, sometime that afternoon. I'd have to get a definitive time, but it was sometime Wednesday afternoon.
Chief, can you talk about the role that other law enforcement agencies, not just necessarily in New York, but here, since this ticket was purchased, in the city of Jackson jurisdiction, how your law enforcement agency is working with JPD and with other more specialized units in terms of being able to help get some answers?
Yes, what we initially do, once we determine that this young lady had been missing for a length of time, we got approval and confirmation from the family, from her mother, to issue a silver alert. Once we did that, we were able to reach out to our local partners to get their assistance in having this issue statewide. And as of this morning, I found that this is somewhat reached the national level, because once an individual is determined to be missing, we appreciate it going to that length rather than just staying local.
How's the family holding up at this point? You said you've been in contact with the mother.
The mother, as with any parent, is very concerned for her child, and we've been empathetic in that regard, because we understand that as a parent, being miles away from your child and haven't heard from her, we understand that. So we've been in the mindset of being able to talk to her whenever she calls, and she's been very receptive of answering our calls.
Have they heard from their daughter since, or has there been any communication whatsoever, you know, since this ticket was purchased, in terms of additional leads?
Without going into detail, we have been tracking activity on that card, but once again, we're looking out, we're reaching out to our partners in law enforcement across the country where this ticket was destined, to find out what they can help us to determine.
I'm just trying to clarify the timeline here. You said that she's been missing since Tuesday, and then the ticket to New York City was purchased on Wednesday afternoon.
Yes.
So what was the incident on Tuesday that made people know that she was not or missing?
We just got a call from her, from a concerned member of the student body, that they wanted to make it known that she needed someone to talk to. And the last time anyone talked to her, like I mentioned, was on the 19th.
Can you say the number again?
Once again, the number here for Jackson State Department of Public Safety is 601-979-2580, and that is 24 hours a day. Please, if you have any information, if you know anyone that has seen her, if you know anyone that has talked to her, please call us, and we encourage any information, any leads that you may have.
And you said that someone said she needed to talk to someone.
Yes, they were just concerned. They were just concerned about her well-being, because they just felt the need that was something they wanted to do. We're looking into the reason behind that, but that's part of what we're doing now, without trying to compromise the investigation, because we don't want to put in from any misleading information out to anyone.
Chief, I'm not trying to get you to just, you know, reiterate what you've already said, but based on what you know at this point and can tell the public, do you have any reason to believe that these actions, that there's anything to suggest foul play at this point?
At this time, no, because based on information we have, based on the information that we have, the ticket was purchased by Ms. Phipps, and that ended in New York, which is the final destination for that ticket that she purchased.